Christine, and thanks 21 Media for having us here. Just so we know who's in the room, hands up all testers. Hands up all engineers. Why is that not the same hands up? Why are testers engineers? I'll still work that one out. I think we should all be engineers. So what I want to talk about today was, in Wigan Hill we went through transformation where we became very agile and teams like got embedded into what I'll call squads and tribes, using Spotify's term. And what it was that we had the old model, which isn't wrong, but it was the old model of, we had a hierarchy. We had a test center of excellence, we had people, but that wasn't the way that people worked. People were embedded inside teams. They didn't really talk to their line manager. You had a line manager of all the SDETs and all the STEs or whatever. But we had STEs and SDETs embedded into their squads. They weren't line managed by them. They were line managed by, well, not even line managed. They were embedded into the squad and they worked with the squad. They didn't work in teams like this. This was an old model. So it didn't represent reality. And the thing about it was then, you had confused responsibility whereby you had a test manager who would say, well, my focus is, or the bonus that I'm getting paid for is, that we must go this way with testing. Testing must be quicker, it must be faster, it must be more agile. But yet they were embedded in squads where they were going, well, you need to test, you also need to do a bit of BA, you need to do a bit of product ownership, you need to do even some of the SDETs were even doing coding and working with it because they worked whatever the squad wanted. So then you had conflict between the two. So you had the function line management and you had the squad in which teams worked in conflict with each other. You had then as well that, how do you get career progression through this type of like system? Because the day-to-day work of people who saw how good you were doing weren't your line manager, weren't the people who were going to pay you the bonus at the end of the day or give you a performance review. So this is more like what the teams were. So you had developers, you had BAs, you had product owners, you had architects, you had analysts, agile people, you had sys engineers, and you had testers embedded within teams, within the tribe. And then they were made up of different development squads in different ways and different ways of working. So this was the actual reality. It wasn't the previous slide where we had that line management. It was now we had people embedded within teams. And yes, you may have had tribe practice leads and that could be a bit of line management. But that was a bit embedded because the development squads were autonomous in themselves. So they were the ones who decided on what people worked on. They decided how they would work, they decided what the engineers would do, what the testers would do, what the architects would do. And together as a team, the whole idea of agile and transformation is that team should decide what to do.